Hello everybody, welcome to the Java example section. In this section, I'm going to set up a program to determine who are above the age of 15 years old in order to receive a vaccine. So first, I'd like to enter the number of students and I would create some arrays to store the student names and ages. And from these arrays, I'm going to determine who are eligible to receive a vaccine. Let us see how we can implement the program. Because I need to accept user input, I need to create a scanner object. Before doing so, I need to import the scanner package. Okay, after the import, I can use it. So I create a prompt. And after the prompt, I can create a scanner object. So the variable scan is actually a reference variable to a scanner object, whose actual parameter is system.in. System.in refers to the keyboard input. Okay, I can receive the user input using the nextInt method of a scanner object. So I use scan.nextInt. Here scan is the reference variable to a scanner object. So after naming the reference variable, I call the method pertaining to the object which the variable is referring to. And the result of the user input will be stored in the variable called numStudents. And by using this variable numStudents, I can set up two arrays to store the student names and ages later. Okay, I created two array references. One is called student and the other is called age. So this reference variable is storing the reference to an array that stores some strings. And the number of elements in this array is denoted by numStudents variable. And we can do similar things to store the age of each student. Okay, I created an object reference called age, which points to an array that stores integers. And the number of array elements for age is also equal to the number of students. After that, I can create two more scanner objects to receive the names and the ages. So after I've created two more scanner objects, I can use it in a for loop. I can prompt the user to input the student names. in order to store the user input to the array, I can do something like this. Here I use next line method for the scan name object reference. So next line refers to accepting some string from the user. So the string received by the from the user will be put in each of the elements of the student array. So more technically, student refers to the object reference variable, and this object reference variable is storing the reference of an array that is going to store some string objects. Of course, an array starts with 0, so we would use I equals 0 as the initial index used in the for loop. We can do similar things for the age component. We can use the scan age reference variable, and for this variable we use the next int method pertaining to a object that receives integer input value, and the integer input value will be stored in each of the elements of the array referenced by the age variable here. And then we can do the comparison using a for loop. If a certain age is larger than or equal to 15, we would print out the student name with the same index. I can also print out the age of that student. So after we have printed out the student names and the corresponding ages, we can actually finish the program by closing all the scanner objects created. We created three scanner objects with these three reference variables. So we can close all these three objects by using the close method. So let us run it by saving it first. I have say four students. The first name is Andy. I got the error here. I haven't added the part here, so let me stop it. I need to add another prompt like this, so that I can let the user input the correct things for each time. So let me run it again. Save it. And run it. For the first name is Andy. The age is 13. The second name is Donnie. The age is 16. The third name is Carol. The age is 15. And the fourth name is, let me think, David. The age is 14. So Bonnie and Carol would be over 15 or exactly equal to 15 years old. So these two students will need to receive a vaccine because they are at least 15 years old. My program is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the best or the most efficient solution. If you can suggest any idea to improve my code, feel free to add your comments below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.